You an esports fan? Prove your knowledge and start winning cash on AlphaDraft Fantasy Esports. This year, we'll pay out over $5 million in prizes to over 50,000 esports fans every single week. To play, first select from hundreds of contests from the hottest esports. Then, choose your team of pros and watch their stats update in real time during games. Right now, we'll match every dollar you deposit up to $250. What are you waiting for? Redeem your deposit bonus and play AlphaDraft now.
Welcome everyone to RGN. First and foremost, want to apologize for all the delays, guys. We don't like delays either, so not a fun situation for anybody involved. We did get the situation sorted out. There was some ping issues, so we finally got everybody happy. Everything is solid in that respect, so we're getting ready to jump into play. Cobblestone's going to be our first map, and that was picked up by Elevate. Train will be the second map of the best of three, and again, I do have a fancy bracket stage. We can just jump back over, see the current stages of our bracket stage here in the RGN Cup. And as we can see, we're currently watching a lower bracket match. Again, X-Elevate and Follow Esports both dropping out in the round of eight. They lost their matches 2-0, but it does look like we're going live here on Cobblestone. All right, here we go. Starting off on the CT side, gonna be X Elevate, Follow Esports, or X Follow Esports. We got Battle of X's. I've been saying it every time I've been talking about this match coming up.
Never lost, Chad.
Yeah, the pun comes out. As here we go, Follow Esports working towards the B bomb site here on their pistol round.
And it will be a commitment from Follow. We do have Elevate stacking four here, as well as a flanker coming through. That'll be Ruru eventually. But first frag goes to Akis, but Follow Esports do not immediately follow it up. That's the second for Akis, but Follow is going to continue their take in. They got to drop these two players really quickly, and they will. Akis and Slummy fall, but now comes the flank. And how much can Ruru do with this?
He'll make his way into the drop areas. Oh, he spots out Wabbit, but letting go of a couple bullets. Nice shot onto Else. All right, all right. Ruru's got something to show as Hades coming up from behind. Ruru with the read, but will go down. Three frags for Hades. Wabbit with two for himself as well. And the pistol round will go the T side's way. And just fairly standard B side execute. And it does work out well.
I feel like with Elevate's setup, that's the best chance you have on pistol round of holding a B take, is having your guy flanking long as quick as possible. Or he didn't hold W the whole way, but it was still pretty fast. And then you stack the rest with four people there. So I mean, that just shows how hard that B bomb site is to hold. And Elevate got the first kill of the round.
Yeah, just nice work by them. And now moving on to the second round, CTs will go for upgraded pistol play. And Desi actually finds Akis first and foremost. And okay, Desi.
This game chat.
Yeah, that's some fun stuff. He jumps around the corner, checks the boost spot, and Peekaboo will find a headshot. So, it's two players down on the CT side. 48 bomb site. Desi's going to find another really nice shot onto Stewie as he's just covering the crawl space area. Ruru finds himself in a 1v5, and I think he's just going to camp it out over here at B.
I can't believe Desi got that jumping shot in the
right
boost spot at long. That's a way to check it. I don't think he was necessarily trying to go for the kill. He was shooting bullets there, but expecting to get the kill, I doubt it. But it's the one shot midair with the Tech 9. I really thought the CT was going to be able to do at least some damage, maybe even a kill. But no kills for X Elevate at all, and they went for almost a force by just having PTR save up for that AWP. Follow Esports once again going to head over towards the B side. And while we're on an eco, we were discussing prior to the match, Follow Esports picking Train when I would have expected a Dust 2 pick from them, but I don't understand the Train pick. I mean, maybe they've been practicing it a lot recently, but primarily they've been strong on Dust 2.
Yeah, I would agree. Luckily for them, we do get Dust 2 as the third map there. So that works out anyhow if we do make it that far. But yeah, as for Train, I've got to think that they've got something new up their sleeve. As if you look at the past statistics, to be fair, they're facing some pretty decent opponents on the map. But usually it's not going their way necessarily. So who knows? We'll find out what they have in store. As Cobblestone, for example, not a bad map at all for Follow Esports either, to be fair. They just went... Oh, actually, no, I'm getting it wrong. That was Mirage versus CLG. I apologize. 16-14. They've got some recent score lines that were fairly close with, again, some top-level teams there. We're not going to see Mirage tonight, but here we go. First rifle round now underway. Follow Esports. Looking like I'm going to send at least one player quick out Broken Wall. That's Desi. And he's been fairly hot at the moment, so not a bad entry to try and rely on here. And Peter, he has been able to save up for an AWP. No utility with it, though.
Yeah, all teams have a, or should have a Desi on their lineup. Or you can send him in solo, working it very slowly, and often he'll net you a frag, as this time he does. Ocean follows it up with a P90. He's keeping that, but Ruru, he'll get two PTR with a nice no-scope flick. That's going to keep his team in the round. I mean, he doesn't get that one. Akis finds himself alone in the 1v2. Follow Esports, two players up. Wabbit and Ocean versus Akis and PTR. Akis takes the fight with Ocean. Ocean misses his spray. And now Wabbit. He is at the broken wall. Akis and PTR approaching. They've spotted out his position. Akis will go down. PTR, no nades. Has to peek him immediately. He's running out of time. Peeks wide and he will get it. And he will have enough time to get that defuse. First round for X Elevate.
Yeah, they will put it on the board. Only surviving with one, Peter should be able to make it back to his op in time, and indeed he does. So that's a good situation. At least he brings that most expensive rifle through to the next round, and Wabbit almost had that 1v2. He knew that the only situation Peter was going to be able to win is if he actually did come up onto the broken wall itself, but not able to get it done, unfortunately. But like I was stating, though, being that they survive with only one player, you can see the buy not too fantastic coming out from the CTs, whereas the Ts, they kind of got everything their hearts desire.
And they're just going to back it up with another B-take. So can they hold one for? Last time, I wouldn't really consider it a hold. As they just won in the end. Desi, once again, peeking out from the broken wall. He's going to lead the charge. Oh, Stewie lurks right through it, and he gets another one through the smoke. He's going to continue firing. Wow. Stewie 2K through the smoke. That's going to be four for him. Potentially looking at the last one, but Slubby is going to get that. That was a trap.
Yeah, that was fantastic work. Stewie sees that smoke, and he's like, I raise you a flashbang. Decided to right-click it in there and just jumps on up and catches Desi. Had already moved out to the kind of plateau there, broken wall and such, and yeah, that's going to be that. Nice work again, Stewie2K. So second round comes in. A lot of that credit to him as moving into this next round. Follow Esports, still enough to get a buy in here. Not exactly the buy they had in the last wave. It did have an AWP and such, but a bit of a different strategy as they send Hades towards B drop area, just anchoring that spot where the rest heading towards A.
And it didn't look like there was a contingency plan in that last round for Follow Esports either. As once that take is initiated, there's no falling back and running through that space. If you can't close the distance right away, that can be a fatal funnel. Stewie2K. And Follow Esports this time going to head towards the A side. Their economy will finally be broken if X Elevate can take this round. Only one player over towards the B side. It was Hades. I expected it to be Desi, but looks like they want him entry fragging towards the A side. Here they come on the other side of the mid door. Akis, he'll grab Ocean and be able to fall back. I lied, else will eventually trade him off. PTR still in the site. This is looking good for Follow Esports. They've actually taken out the connector, but now they got to deal with PTR in the bomb site. He's split off from his teammates as they're still fighting for connector.
And he will whip one shot. They are finally going to surround him. Stewie fires back on a Hades, very lower the remaining T's as we look at the bomb planted. Slemmy spots Else on the bomb site itself. We'll see how this retake continues as Desi's going to be in a prime spot underneath that balcony area. He blindsides Stewie, and Else follows it up onto Slemmy. So little hit points, but they're able to work together and get it done. Follow Esports with their fourth.
I can't remember which guy jumped out of window there or up top, but he really should have checked.
Yeah, you got to check under
Desi
that.
Was going to be there. He checked one side, but not the other side. But, oh, I'm glad it's just a mumble crash, Chad. We've had an update tonight, and I thought we were going to have to double reschedule this game, but it's like it's just
nope.
The mumble.
Thank goodness. So I'm sure they'll get that figured out in just a moment here, as, of course, team communication sort of important here in Counter-Strike, semi-ish, I suppose. So, of course, we're going to allow them to get that figured out. But four rounds already, again, for Follow Esports, and moving into this next round, again, CTs were able to put two on the board, but their economy, it's all right. It's enough to get some M4s. So FAMAS on Slemmy, Peter going with the glass cannon. So we'll see if he can make that work. As he actually did have a pretty swift shot when he was holding down that bomb site, but didn't really have any help once they actually surrounded him. And obviously with that up, well, you'd like to just hit every single shot, but once he
they've been doing a good job isolating his AWP as well. We haven't seen PTR get many entry frags, and I think that's just due to the way Follow Esports is approaching. I mean, towards the B side, he hasn't gotten a chance. There's always been smokes and flashes. It's been primarily later in the round that PTR has been getting those frags, and that's all due to the way Follow Esports is taken.
So we are good to go yet again. Round 7 is now alive. Follow Esports seemingly good to go. So we're going to see Akis push up aggressively towards Llama Peter. There's the entry frag like you were talking about. Gets a boost up on drop. And we'll find one. Desi does trade off. He takes down Akis on the opposite end of things. And now some pressure coming from Long A. Desi's got some teammates with them. Another really nice shot there from Peter, though, to at least drop one more as they're farthering up Long.
This is not a good look from Follow Esports. They Molotov off the Nectar. They don't smoke it. PTR's right there with an AWP. How do you expect to cross into the bomb site with an AWP inside a connector? We'll finally get that smoke down. Is it too late? It's Ellis. It's just down to 7 HP. PTR Slemmy still up. And he knows if he's going to win this, he likely has to try to make an aggressive move here before he plants the bomb. There it is. PTR goes down. Now Slemmy peeking from the window. This and he has a nade.
Oh, no.
Here it comes. 7 HP. And he doesn't get it.
It wasn't close enough. Counter-Strike nades at its finest, as I think that did one hit point worth of damage. He's now down to 7. Slemmy peeking wide here. But Else with the read. He's making lots of footsteps in the headshot angle. Else, very nice work as he finds the 3K, 1v2 with like eight hit points. That was some fantastic work, and comes down to, again, the 1v1 duels. He took one with Peter and then follows it up on a Slemmy.
Butterfingers, Chad. I can't believe X Elevate dropped that. That was their round. And Follow Esports made a critical error. I mean, if the rifler's in connector or automatic rifler's in connector, I guess it's not as big of a deal, but a Molotov is not good enough to stop any connector players from shooting you. They weren't even peeking the connector, and PTR ended up getting 3 frags, but I think he was a little thirsty for the last one.
Yeah, indeed. As we're going to see Eco for the CT side. Hades attempting to work a little drop to spot out Slemmy, but no damage exchanged here. As Follow Esports on the anti-Eco. Want to build up a bit of a bank here. Wabbit finds a pick onto Stewie as he attempts to push up on the broken wall. We see Peter actually, he's going to push out Long A, so might be able to find something for that. Desi is making sure that no one lurks through and actually will find him. So 3-on-5 as all 3 CTs actually in the drop-down area looking for a boost. Hades might be in for a surprise here, but himself hard to hit, and now only Ruru left in connector. He's gonna see if he can get anything done here.
The ugliest skin in the game doesn't deserve a kill. That Boreal Forest.
How dare he?
But 6-2 for Follow Esports. They're developing a good half, a decent bank, X Elevate. They do have enough to go for the force buy. A lot of teams would go for the force buy in this position, but with PTR on your squad, you really want keeping AWP in his hands as much as possible, as we saw what happened in the last gun round. And X-Elevate got a bunch of kills with PTR's AWP. Might have even been 4. I think it was 3, though. And X-Elevate gonna go ahead and save here. And if Follow Esports can take this map, we may see this upset, because the next two maps are you gotta figure, I'm not so sure about the train pick, but they picked it. So you have to think they're confident on it right now. And Dust 2, that's traditionally one of their stronger maps.
Yeah, certainly. So, see how this continues as Else finds 2 for himself. actually comes up on the flank towards Hades in drop and plus himself an AK. So that'll be a little bit of damage dealt here. Desi will find Ruru as they are trying to make it up onto the A bomb site. Else actually still lurking towards B. Might try and cut off a rotation or even just maybe hunt for the weapons. I'm not entirely certain what he'll go for here. T's, they have a little bit of money, so see if they want to take that away from Stewie. But bomb being planted. Looks like CT's just going to stay around B. Of course, Stewie wanted to keep his weapon around. Slemmy, on the other hand, I guess he's just in protection mode, making sure no one flanks through back halls. And Stewie will find L, so again, should be able to keep this rifle in play.
And make this 7-2 now for Follow Esports, and no AK for Stewie. 2K. Of course, he did have that sick 4K. And I think it was partly due to an M4, and then he picked up an AK. God, that round was sick. Slemmy will get himself an AK. Follow Esports. We did throw away a couple of weapons there, but with their current economy, it's not so bad. It's worth it to try to keep that X Elevate economy extremely low. Let's check the buy from X Elevate. I assume that op from PTR is coming out. So we're going to get as full of a nade set as he can. Wouldn't surprise me if Follow Esports just hit back to the A-bomb site once more. Desi's been good from the broken wall. They haven't done it in a little bit. So we'll see if Desi can find any more entry frags from this broken wall position. This will creep him out here slowly. Slemmy, oh, this is a quick take from Follow Esports. Trying to switch the pace up, but they're paying for it. It's Slemmy and Stewie2K combined to get 4 so far. Slemmy with 3. So Wabbit all alone here. He's going to try to drop down from the broken wall. He realizes he's getting flanked. Some good awareness right there. Probably would have went down to that. Oh, nice shot onto Ruru, but Slemmy with the 4K. And drop can be hard to hold at times, but Slemmy can do it.
Yeah, Slemmy was playing like a mini game there, like kill the falling terrace. He actually had a smoke up, and the Follow Esports peaked pretty much one by one. So he just had one terrace to focus on that's diving in at him, and he's got an AK and just sprays them down as they jump through. So I'm not a big fan of how Follow Esports just attempted to take drop as throwing numbers in there more than just, again, single file jumping through. Again, I think they could have had a little bit of a better time there, but Slemmy, I'm sure he's happy about it. Like he'd stated, 4K in the round. And Follow Esports, that was the first kind of quick pace. Well, I guess other than maybe pissed around, say that as well. But stuff there, I don't know if we'll see that again, as, again, brought very little in the former's results. But Follow Esports much more spread out this time. Working towards A a little bit, poking and prodding towards drop and broken wall, but no commitment as of yet.
I'm wondering if the reason they didn't go for the fast into B was because of what Stewie2K did to them before, but maybe they just wanted to go quickly this time, or last time. Follow Esports thinking about some connector play. They're going to fall back towards the A side. We do have PTR as well as Akis. PTR is going to fall back a bit, look for the shot. He's going to whiff it. Does significant damage onto Desi. I think it was Desi anyways. But Follow Esports still trying to take up long. Akis makes his way around the corner, but not quick enough. PTR is there to ensure the trade. Already from connector. Wow, Slemmy misses a bunch of shots. Ruru to follow. PTR dead as well. And Stewie2K needs a 3K.
So makes it up to connector. Nice take here for Follow Esports. Makes it out. What a quick flip there. Very nice work, as he's got two more to deal with. One towards the bomb site. Desi very low. This incendiary should flush him out. It's a little off its mark, but does at least worry Desi, as he's actually sent down to 3 hit points. He momentarily takes more damage. And I think Stewie maybe thinks, well, that Molotov maybe just off its mark. But no, it was there, but re-peeking his Desi with 3 hit points, and he does secure it. But what a flick, though, coming through a connector. That was really,
oh, yeah,
nice shot.
That shot made me a believer for a moment. Right. And then he missed the second one. I was like, okay, my faith is gone. But Follow Esports have avoided the save entirely this match, and X Elevate still stuck in that economic trap. It's Follow Esports with a chance here to guarantee themselves 10 rounds. And this would put X Elevate on the save once more. And this is not a position in this map that they can afford to save any longer, as it's 1-for-1 thus far in the round. Only guy at A, Akis, on the other side of mid here. Under siege from Follow Esports, that's the first one to go down. Akis almost got a second one, but the trade was good. Now follow Esports. They have connector smoke. This was a key error last time. Top flat out. Ruru getting incredibly aggressive. He'll bring down two. Now it's Wabbit for this AWP clutch. Tons of AWP clutches here for follow Esports, but doesn't look like it's going to happen this time as Wabbit will fall. X elevate. Finally, we'll put follow Esports on the save.
Four rounds for them as well here, as like you were stating, financially speaking, follow Esports not in a good spot. So save round, and I'm curious what they're going to go for here on their first eco. As
I mean, they could just bet the half right here.
Yeah, in theory they definitely could, considering the financial situation of the CT side is not good at all. So yeah, like you're stating.
Last time they rushed B though, they got wrecked, and that's the only thing I really see working on this force pile rush like this.
We'll see. Maybe they can capitalize on Akis in the stairwell. I don't know about this, as they're going to hop past long. Ocean finally peeking. Does one of the half-sea peaks. Not really, though. He checks, but not exactly as thorough as he should have been. And two frags going the way of the T side. So that's some nice work. Ruru is still deep in the back of the bomb site. Desi finds Stewie, though, in the connector door. Wabbit walking right up to the crawl space and does go down. And this is looking like it will be Elevate able to hold on. Hades whiffing that shot. They know exactly where he's at with his AWP. Pop flash goes up from Ruru. Gonna try and take another angle of attack here as up from above. Will whiff yet again. And Slemmy and Ruru. Nice hold at that A bomb site.
Yeah, they're gonna wish they had force bot entirely that last round, because they could have stole it. And that would have probably been the whole half for them. But X Elevate. Despite having a shaky start, they're going to put themselves in a decent spot in the next half to take this one. Follow Esports, though, still have only had to save one time. That's not bad at all on your T side. Slemmy botches his smoke. I was wondering if he's just going to play it off like he did it on purpose or something and play behind it. But not going to happen. So follow Esports. Looking for a drop-down pick, as Hades is here. Trying to look for Slemmy. But Stewie2k and Slemmy, despite the early happenings, later on have shut down drop as well as Broken Wall. And that's good news for Elevate. But had they done that from the get-go, this would have been a pretty different half.
Yeah, it definitely is. Drop down now in control as they smoke in Molly on in. Peter, though, landing. He's off the head of Hades as he tries to make it through the window. Ocean able to capitalize as we'll find a 4-on-3. Now, where do they go? Looks like it will be an A-side take coming up from middle. Akis, he has no idea. They're going to pop their heads through the smoke. And Wabbit able to backstab Akis on that middle ramp. We'll continue up into the bomb site. Slemmy jumps out of the balcony, so going to try and find some aggressive footing here. And he does blindside Desi, so Wabbit alone 1v2.
Then the bomb site sticking together as X Elevate, and Slemmy and Stewie, the rotators, are going to get it done. And in that 2-on-3, or I can't remember if it was a 3-on-3 or 3-on-4, but X Elevate was trying to rotate through to connector, and Follow Esports had one guy there. It was Akis playing from the mid ramp. He got blindsided by the guy's mid because he was so worried about the guys coming from connector from Follow Esports. But I think that's just due to Follow Esports staying silent enough at mid to make Akis think there's more than one guy potentially coming from connector. Either way, nice recovery by X Elevate. And maybe even taking a seventh round to end things. But you see Follow Esports has been dissuaded from taking that broken wall position.
Yeah, definitely. They haven't been going there too often, as Peter looking for the boost in drop. And he does find it yet again. You can throw that in every once in a while, and if it converts, you got an opera like Peter that's not going to miss in that close range avenue. And works out very well. Stewie heading towards Broken Wall and wants a repeat performance here, as Slemmy does find Ocean. Trying to work that drop down yet again. Slemmy putting it on lock, though. Desi with a insta headshot, and he gets taken down to 11, though. So be a little bit fragile. Elsk with the 1D gone to Stewie. But he will be taken down thereafter. 2-on-3 as they got drop down control, but what do they do with it? Little do they recognize that A is actually open for business.
And Ruru will flank. Desi Wabbit wasn't ready for that Ruru flank, so X Elevate I thought that was going to be a runaway hat from Follow Esports, but X Elevate do a good job bringing it back. Four rounds to end the half. So, still probably going to win their map pick, in my opinion.
We'll see here. I was actually told via word of mouth, I could be completely wrong on this, but X Elevate just played versus Liquid, I think today. It was 21-17 that they lost Cobblestone, but they had a lead of 14-6, where, again, Liquid able to push it to overtime. So we'll see here. I don't have the stats on the side, so as much as I just gave you some numbers, it's not a lot to go off of. But nonetheless, we'll see how this next
metrics
half goes.
Chat.
Right. All of the numbers. So we do have a couple giveaways to talk about here, guys, as on our channel specifically, got a Battle Scarred AK-47 Vulcan giveaway at 4,000 followers. So if you guys haven't made your way on over to our channel on Azubu, feel free. And all you need to do, register for our account and drop us a follow. You are eligible. Once we hit that mark, it'll basically be at the end of a broadcast that when we hit that mark, we'll do that giveaway inside of chat. And anybody that's a follower, you are eligible to grab that giveaway. So on top of that, well-worn Op Asimov at 20 subscribers. And I think we are around 17. So I think we're three away from giving that out. So again, shout out to anybody that has followed or subscribed to our channel, as we do really appreciate all the support. As just waiting for these players to ready up so we can go live into our second half of play. This is map number one. That pool, Cobble, Train, and then Dust 2, best of three. First lower bracket match we're broadcasting here. And again, really nice start for the T-side quality sport, but Accelerate, they do bring things back in. Now have a very competitive scoreline moving into their T-side, which, again, I feel like this map is... It's T-sided if the CT team doesn't have good setups on the B-bomb side. That's kind of my consensus. Otherwise, there's actually some teams that don't mind starting on the CT side, because if you have that kind of potent play, well, your defense is going to be pretty solid.
Yeah, it's so random, I guess is the word for it, at that B-bomb site. And we see teams that we've listed previously as good at it sometimes struggle, but I'm not sure if they'll be able to withstand X Elevate's pressure over towards that side. But I'm still hung up on the map pool, because I feel if we see these teams meet, you'd see Train as the third map if it was going to be in here. But since Follow Esports didn't pick Train, or I mean they picked Train and they didn't pick Dust 2, and then that Dust 2, one out of three chance of being selected. It's a great map pool for them. And if they could just take this map, they will have another upset. And if they do well tonight and beat X Elevate, I think we're going to be seeing even greater odds for them than we are seeing here. I mean, had they not had that performance over 3-sup not too long ago, maybe wouldn't see those 2-1 odds that we're having on Lounge currently. Like, we are going to be going live just in a second. Ocean was not the last player to ready up, shockingly. so that was a good thing.
Yep. Record breaker there. As it's actually, it's Wabbit's turn. Wabbit, really nice guy. Opportunity to meet him at UBC LAN here in British Columbia. Quite a few of these players Canadian here on the Follow Esports side.
That's a tragedy.
Sad times, right? They still make pretty damn good Counter-Strike players, as much as we're not seem to be that threatening, but...
Congratulations on the new Prime Minister.
Right? It's very exciting. Apparently, everybody all I've been seeing from other countries is just talking about how handsome our new Prime Minister is. Like, there's nothing on the form of any policy that he would ever feel like implementing. It's all about, is he the sexiest politician? It's bizarre. Like, seriously, look at some mainstream media from anywhere outside of Canada. It's quite funny. Quite funny how that works.
That's
how we look at our celebrities, though, and I guess you could still pin them as a bit of a celebrity, right? But I'm excited to see how it goes. Not that we really want to get into politics, but yeah, Canada, some
like
new
all
stuff.
Those girls for Harper picks prevailed.
Right? Yes, Harper is gone. Yeah, if you guys didn't hear about that, it's safe enough to talk about on stream. There's basically females sending pictures to people if they voted for anybody but the Conservatives to make sure Harper got out. So when you got a motivation like that, apparently people will do a lot of stuff. So anyhow,
maybe we'll have a similar thing against Trump here in America.
That, there we go. Get it started, Laser. Get that trend going.
I'm the wrong gender, chat.
I suppose, yeah. But maybe there's some people
that,
interested.
Trump would win.
If you guys are interested, you should tweet at Laser Jesus to get that going. If you're interested in his pictures for not voting for Trump.
I mean, it wouldn't even be rated R. It'd be like that one rating only reserved for abhorrent films, like NR-17.
Oh, God.
I don't know if you still have the same rating system up there.
I think it's fair. I believe that we do. I believe so, but I'm not the biggest movie buff, to be fair. Producer Kyle, do we have the same movie rating system in Canada versus the States? It's different. All right. Kyle, coming in hot. Beautiful.
That's weird.
Yeah, that is a little bit odd, to be honest.
So, but do you have rated R movies or PG-13?
Yeah, we do have rated
movies?
R, and we've got, yeah, we do PG-13, and we do, I think there's PG, PG-13, you got R, 18A, 14A, okay, that's a thing, and then rated G for general. I think that's pretty much it. So, that's pretty much what you guys have, is it not? Or is there
we don't have. Okay, I might be completely wrong, but I don't think we have a 14A or an 18A. I don't know what the A stands for there.
It's a company thing. Okay, interesting. Okay. Interesting.
I'm done with your ratings for Summit. You got PG-13 in R, Chad. That's you need to talk to that about your new.
That's about as far as it goes.
Prime Minister. Speaking of movies,
I was
gonna
bring up
for
some Star Wars, right? Is that where you're going,
yes.
Laser? Did you get some tickets for that?
No.
No?
I was told by my family member that, like, the internet was shut down, she said, for Star Wars tickets.
Oh, like as in
the whole internet, like, wow.
The whole internet, the tube was just constricted momentarily as the internet just couldn't flow through there. Interesting. Yeah, I know Kyle, our producer. I think he got, like, what? 7 tickets or something like that.
Him and his 7 tickets? That's just hoarding.
I think they're front rows. Well, it's for him. It's for the friends.
Oh, and anybody that hasn't seen the 3D interactive video of of the land speeder cruising through Tatooine, like post episode 6, and you can literally look around like 3D landscape with the video as you're cruising. It's so cool.
There you go. And 18A means adult accompanied. Kyle, thank you very much. Anyhow, just letting you guys, just clarifying as, Laser, look at this. We got a Counter-Strike match going on. Who knew? As Wabbit, he has graced us with his presence. So live we go into pistol round number 2 of this best of 3.
I wonder where did he go?
Right?
That was a long,
or something.
Long delay. Now, here we go. X elevate, T side now. One member with utility being Slemmy. And the rest rocking that armor. It will be a B side play. This is deja vu of the first half pistol round, except for Desi would be pushing through. He'd be Ruru in this situation, but here we go. Follow Esports with a brilliant hold thus far as they bring down both of the drop players, Ruru and PTR, Stewie Decay. To get the first for X elevate, as else will fall. So inferior numbers for X elevate, and they still have not gotten the bomb down. Not a good look for them thus far. They can just get the bomb down. They did salvage something from this, but follow Esports starting off both halves.
Yeah, really nice work from them. As like you were stating, kind of similar situation on that B bomb site take, but the.